Battery. Hey, I can hear you now. Hey,
imagine that.
You know what's going to be interesting? For today's stream, when I go back and I want to watch it, I want to see how this headset now compares to in your system compared to in mine.
Right.
Because I sound like I'm talking through a muffled diaper in mine.
I noticed that the other day, and in fact, I remember we tried my circuit, and it didn't work because there was too much noise.
Yeah.
So I'm redesigning it to do the same thing, basically, where you can turn up and down ATC individually, the intercom individually, and without all the noise. So I'm kind of making a compromise. I took out the compressor circuitry, and I'm keeping the amplifier circuitry, but I'm only using the amplifier circuit to increase the signal level of the 400 hertz side tone.
Ah, okay.
So everything else in that circuit remains passive. There should be no interference. And if there is, it's all your fault.
Sounds like a plan to me. All right. I wouldn't expect anything more.
Okay, but we still need to talk to ground and tower at this airport.
Beep, beep. Open charts 4 hours later.
Yeah. KLFT has no charts? What? Okay.
Well, stars.
Yeah. Okay. Does it have any SIDs? No SIDs. Good. So it's vector to vector. Victor.
Pin that.
Yeah, we're going to GLS. Let's open up those charts. Open charts for GLS. Taxi charts, we'll pin that. All right. Oops. Okay. KLFT, show me the chart. Okay, well, we are on, there's going to be no ATIS for this, and there's going to be no tower, and no ground control. So basically, we can do whatever we want. We can open up our flight plan in flight.
Okay. What runway is it we're going into on Lafayette? Or,
well, we won't know, because we're VFR.
Wait, no, wait, okay, wait, we're not doing long, gosh dang it, my charts did not, there we go, close that, I got opened up the wrong one, so runway 14, no wonder it wasn't making sense. Boy, this seems exceptionally lagged behind today.
Yeah, I'm noticing that too. I'm noticing that, okay, geo position is working. Okay, yeah, for some reason, you got geolocation turned on, so that seemed to clear it up for me over here. I'm gonna go ahead and turn on our external hover.
All right, why is it so dark out here? All the lights are coming on. Are we set for real time?
Oh, I do need the mouse.
Right now.
All right.
See, told you I had to stick it up.
Oh, it's Fly DC Jets. So, oh yeah, no, Fly DC Jets. We were just talking about how busy you were going to be today. I was also telling Ray that you were going to show us your Georgetown's city bird sanctuary. Apparently, they're really, yeah, they're really proud of their buzzards.
Proud of the buzzard tower, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Gives a whole new meaning to you're not cleared to buzz the tower.
Or buzz off.
Okay.
Get that out of the way of the...
Yeah.
I said down! There.
What you should do is just mount it right here in front of you.
wouldn't affect our flying.
Yeah.
There. Okay.
All right. Oh, you left your bacon light on.
Bacon? I don't have a bacon light. I have a bacon light. I don't think...
You get enough air? Go.
Yeah, I got enough air.
See, I'm one who doesn't like anything.
I wonder if that's because you lived in ships most of your life. And all that air was stale.
I don't know. To be honest with you.
All right, well, this is going to be fun. We don't have ground control. We don't have tower, so we can pretty much just go with the winds.
No ground control, so we don't have to worry about Major Tom?
We don't have to worry about Major Tom or anyone.
All right.
Yep. I want to double check one last thing. I want to go here. Hey, our bleeds are up. Good. Oh, one thing I wanted to show you. Remember last time you were here, I wanted to show you the parking camera?
Yes. Very nice.
Yeah.
I like it very much.
Yeah, so that will give you a kind of a good idea if you're lined up or not.
Nice. On 12, they got to get all that stuff all wrapped back up and working again.
Yeah.
Alrighty, so let's go ahead and...
Let's do some engine startage.
It's a sight you and Lori sound... What? Oh, should get a photo with the buzzer. Oh, yeah, it's absolutely... It's the number one... I heard it's your number one requested tourist attraction.
That's too funny. All right, are you ready, Captain?
Hey, wait. Is that a trick question, whether I'm ready or not?
Yeah, it kind of is.
Okay, well, hang on here. All right, I'm ready now.
You just busted so many regulations. The biggest one being, it's supposed to be, all right, listen carefully, 8 inches from bottle to throttle.
It is now.
It is now, okay. Crazy. Well, I guess then we should just get going and
okay.
Get this shit show on the way, on the road. Flight plan's filed, yes. Weight and balance is checked. Notice to airmen's is checked. Charts are on board. Weather is definitely on board. Yep. We're flying.
In the clouds.
In the clouds. What's our frame rates today?
Our frame rates are a whopping 46.
Nice. Okay, parking brake is set. Throttles are at... Throttles... Our throttles are at idle.
What did you say?
Gear levers down.
I'm so clipping that for the next YOLO.
That was good. Okay, my friend. Avionics master to on.
Avionics masters to on. On.
Right. Voltage check. We'll do a voltage check. Gens are off. Triple feed bus is good. But it's only being fed by battery and external power. Okay, so voltages are good. Fuel check. Plenty of fuel on board for this trip.
Yep.
Enunciators.
Enunciating.
Check. Yeah. Looks good. We don't worry about the lower one. Fire gear stall horns. Now, I've been having trouble with these horns in that they don't really work anymore. That one works.
What, the tuba, the trumpet, butt horn?
The stall horn.
Oh.
You know, kind of the really important one.
Oh.
I think it's because I moved directories and I screwed up some links.
Oh.
Flaps are up. Props idle detent. Yeah. Fuel levers are cut off. Panel lights as required. Left, right.
Yeah.
Oh, what's going on here?
That's not important, is it?
It's kind of important. There you go.
Well, fancy that. It works.
It works, yeah. ATIS, we definitely do not have, but let's try it anyway. 3405.
Oh, now, yeah, you know what? Because you're running VATSIM, we probably won't get it.
Yeah. And we are not getting it. Okay.
Yeah. Well, I wish there was a way that ATIS would sound if VATSIM wasn't covered.
Right.
But then again, what VATSIM would be is considered correct ATIS, probably would not be what XPlane considers correct ATIS.
Right.
So I could understand why it's just blocked out.
Okay, I've got my barometer set to 30.2.
Yeah, and because looking at our, what is our?
Field elevation looks like it's around 30 feet.
Yeah, so that looks good to me.
Close enough for government work.
Yeah, I mean, you mean YOLO work.
Flat controls.
All right.
All right, free and hopefully correct.
Hang on here. Okay, it's just fine. Okay.
Doors and hatches are closed.
Yep.
Beacons on. Cabin briefing safety. Okay, ground power is required. Yep, ground power is definitely on. Bleeds and blows are off. Click, click, click are off. Avionics master, all radios.
Yep.
We're just going to leave the comm one on for
yeah.
the time being. Both engine auto ignitions on.
Auto ignitions. That's
top right on the panel.
Oh, top right here.
There you go.
Arm over here. All right.
And, we got a problem right here. Okay, be right back.
We should see lightage.
Maintenance!
Maintenance!
I know, Sogan, right? Yeah, Beech is really flying his sim today, I know. You're getting quite the reputation of not flying your sim.
Yeah, probably. I can understand why.
All right.
Hey, welcome aboard, Sogan. Good to have you. Yeah, Beach House actually does fly this once in a great while.
All right, so time to go. Focus in the tower, cab. Talk with y'all in a bit. Yep, looks forward to it there, Fly DC Jets. Enjoy. All right.
Okay. Okay, auto ignitions are on. Yep, and indicated.
Yep.
Prop area clear on the right.
And we're clear. Whoa.
What?
Did you see that whiskey truck go by?
No, there's a whiskey truck here?
All right, well, never mind. I got sidetracked. Yeah, you're clear over here.
Okay. Fuel levers. Low idle.
Low, yeah, prop, fuel, and then all these, right?
Nope. Nope. Fuel levers, low idle.
Fuel levers.
Yep.
Where are those? What? Oh, low. Okay, there it says low idle.
Look at that!
I was taught how to read in the fifth grade.
How long has it been? Dear God.
It wasn't with the right color crayons.
I'm sorry, I don't have that newfangled psychedelic look in here. All right, you ready to turn on an engine?
Let's spin one of these bad boys.
Let's spin number two.
All right, let's do it.
Okay. That should go right up to start.
And then looking for the...
Yeah, looking for oil pressures.
All right.
Let the tits come down. Awesome. All right, kick on generator number two.
All right, generator number 2 is on.
And disconnect ground power, please.
And which one is your ground? This one?
Yeah.
Okay. Perfect. All right. Disconnected.
Awesome. All right. Number 2 is stabilized. Spin number 1, please.
And the turbines on the blades go round and round, round and round. Round and round. Now. All right.
And generator number 1 online, please.
And generator 1 is online.
Cool.
We got her started.
Dang.
YOLO 209. Going to be airborne real soon.
Yeah. Okay, looks like we got 2 good ones.
All right.
Okay, ground power is definitely off. Feather check the props, please.
And that's these.
Yeah. Good feathers. All right. Bottom center of the right-hand panel, stall worn pitots on.
All right. Pitots, stall.
Yeah, they're on. We got it. And everything else is off except for that guy, which is coming up. Engine instruments check one last time. They look good. Leads and lowers going on. I'll set the cabin altitude. Okay. Okay, turn on the radios. What's guard?
122.8. There we go.
Okay, let's set these up. This one I'm going to set for VFR.
Okay.
Barometer is 3002. Actually, you can turn it this way too.
Ooh, you can get fancy by playing with it knob.
Yeah, and then this one I am not so lucky. For this one, we're going to do terrain and then barometer.
Okay.
There. So this one will just show you either, a bunch of different colors, depending on the severity of the impact. And you'll see it when we take off. The red will start to disappear, being replaced by yellow, and eventually green, and then eventually black, which means not a factor.
Wow. Interesting. All right.
This one is just standard navigation. And look at that. Charts. Airport charts. And so we could take, looks like we're ready for,
right.
2-2 right.
So, yep. Oh, we're going to do 2-2?
We can do any runway you want.
Well, we don't have weather, so we're going to have to guess at it, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah, I don't care. Let's just go ahead and... Now, are we squawking 1200?
Yes, we are.
Okay. All right. That's the only last thing I can think of that would be importante.
Auto feather armed?
Auto feather armed. Which one is that one?
Bottom row. There you go.
Okay.
Okay. That's exactly what we want on the lower indicators.
I've heard that green is good.
Green is good.
All right.
Yeah.
I've just heard that theory, you know.
Okay, prop levers full.
Prop levers full.
And fuel levers full.
Fuel levers full.
Okay, I'm going to release the parking brakes. You're going to do a brake check, and then she's all yours, Capitan. All
right.
Brakes off. Brake all right. Check good.
Yep.
All right.
All right, so let's see here. We're going to go 2-2.
2-2.
Which is going to be... that way.
Yeah, 2Z left, it looks like. We're going to take Lima directly to the threshold.
All right. I'll tell you what, isn't this kind of a scenery a lot better set up?
Yeah, it really is. Okay, and our first direct. Is LLA. So we'll do direct.
Oh no, is the scenery messed up in this thing?
That's interesting. Huh. Maybe it is. I've had more trouble with my scenery.
Well,
in Texas.
You know what? I need to get in there and fix it because it has all to do with priorities.
See, I thought I fixed all that priority stuff too. Hey, Peter, welcome aboard.
Oh, is it Peter's here?
Will we be going to Port Uranus today?
Nope.
I don't know why. I don't know why the scenery does this, but yeah, weird. So over off in the distance, we have scenery, but not here at the airport. Interesting.
You know what?
What?
I gotta make a U-turn to do.
Yeah, I was wondering where we were going.
Yeah. Instead of paying attention where I was going, I was checking out the, Oh, did you announce our taxi and intentions?
Oh, no. Lafayette traffic, this is Yellow 209. We are taxiing Papa Lima to 22 right Lafayette traffic.
See, because there's no Papa indications for this taxiway here. So, I just assumed that it was...
Yeah.
So, what this is a cause from... We must be outside of the Texas border, but this is Louisiana... We're in Louisiana.
We're in Louisiana.
So, yeah, it's a priorities.
Yeah, because this is all water that it's showing.
Yeah, well, that kind of...
That sucks.
Yeah.
Thanks, X-Plane.
All right, so taxiing in position, runway 22. And see, this says 22 left.
Well, up there. This is 22 right, right here.
Oh.
Right here, right here, right here, right,
yeah.
Right here.
Oh, dang. This one?
This one, yes.
Okay.
Lafayette traffic, Yellow 209, departing runway 22 right, departing to the southwest Lafayette traffic.
All right, ready?
Ready!
All right, before takeoff checklist?
Before takeoff checklist. Landing lights on, taxi lights off.
Yep, taxi lights, landing lights on, taxi lights off.
Okay, we are mode C, definitely, as indicated on VATSIM. Okay, and takeoff trim is set.
And flaps are not.
Yep, good catch. That was actually just next on my checklist.
Okay.
All right, flaps takeoff indicated.
All right.
All you!
All right, here we go.
And we're gonna climb straight out to our waypoint.
Oh man. Finally, they got some power lines here.
Oh my God. Look at this. Look at that. Look how much our frame rates are going to paint that crap.
Hey, you picked the wrong runway.
What?
We're not going to make it.
Well, you got to throttle up. That's why.
I did. You know, we're going to barely clip that building.
Oh my God.
Gear up.
Yeah. All right, now I'll pull your throttles back to the safe range. Perfect. Okay. We're not going to clear it. Well, we're only at like 30% throttle.
Well, I forget. It's not like a Boeing where I can take off with 60% thrust.
Right.
All right, so we're climbing to...
Wait a minute. This is Louisiana. Maybe the scenery is correct.
Damn.
Maybe the whole thing is flooded.
All right. I'm going to drop nose down here, bring the speed up a little bit.
Okay. If you want, we can go, we can hit engage autopilot, do all that fun stuff. And if you want to follow the GPS flight plan, you just hit nav.
Okay, so how do you, okay, so let's check out your system. How does that work now?
Okay, so first thing we can do,
let me drop down.
Set vertical speed down here. So okay. Hit vertical speed, set it to what you want.
Let's just do 1,200 for now.
Okay, and then back down here, altitude, hit that twice.
Okay.
Actually, hit it one more time since we're going to be setting.
Oh, wow, I see.
Yeah.
So we want 11.
11.5.
And how do I do 11.5 on
here? Just keep spinning. Keep spinning.
Okay.
There you go. Keep spinning.
I don't see it doing. Oh, there we go. Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Now you can hit AP.
Okay.
VS and altitude. And you can track to the first waypoint using a nav, which I've already got set up if you want to do that.
Yep.
There we go.
All right, so flaps are up after takeoff checklist.
All right, after takeoff, auto feathers are off.
Auto feathers off. That's auto.
Bottom row?
Huh? Hang on here. Where's a...
Bottom row.
Oh, the single switch. Okay.
There you go.
All right.
Checker fuel?
It's still fuel fine.
All right. All right, and then cap briefing, and that's it.
All right.
Climb out checklist complete.
All right.
Yeah, we're in the clouds. Yuck.
Well, imagine that. Flying involving clouds.
I know.
The blasphemy.
It's crazy.
Yes. What's the reflection? That is apparently... Lafayette underwater.
Yeah.
Apparently it's a new public project where they've guaranteed everybody a pool.
Yeah. We're socializing weather. No, it's not flooding. Everyone has a pool now. With alligators.
Those aren't alligators. That's a trash removal system.
Well, there you go.
You've seen how they eat trash.
Yeah. All right. Well, I guess we should be in touch with Atlanta Center.
Should we?
Well, we're VFR. We shouldn't have to be in touch with anybody.
Well, true. We don't see if Fly DC Jets is online yet then either, huh?
No. Can't tell. I'm going to put in center just in case they want to talk to us. 13297.
Yeah. So we're ready when we hear that beep, beep, beep.
Yeah.
But although Jacksonville, we should not be. Actually, we're in the ZHU area of control.
So this won't even matter, will it?
Because, yeah, we should be ZHU. Yeah, we're in ZHU.
Okay.
I guess if we would have done our proper research, we would have known that.
Yeah.
All right, climbing through 7,200.
All right.
For 11,500.
Just want to double check our audio settings. Well, that's a really exciting view out there, isn't it?
Well, it always is.
We should probably go to... Oh, this one. There we go. Oh. Since there's nothing to see outside.
Right.
Why is the scenery all screwed up just in this area? Like, right around the eastern Texas border to Louisiana.
It really honestly has to do with the priorities, how you set it up in your INI.
But I've got this, I got the mesh all the way down at the bottom. Literally.
No, I know, but we'll take a peek, because I guarantee you've got a culprit.
I have a
It
cold.
Doesn't... Yeah, we'll take a look at your scene. See, yeah. I have still yet to do... I need to do ortho for Alaska. But I'm going to hold off because I was reading about ortho still isn't been completely synchronized for XPlane 12 yet.
Really?
Yeah. The American Venice.
Yeah,
there you go, Sogan. Oh, we got GLS Tower.
Who?
GLS Tower. I don't know what that is.
That's where we're going.
Oh, GLS Tower. Oh. All right.
MSY Tower. GLS ATIS is on. We must have just flown into their coverage area.
All right, so we're going through 10,000 feet. Landing lights coming off.
Sweet.
So I learned a lesson today.
What's that?
Have you ever, like, jumped into the shower and realized you didn't have the soap that you're supposed to use?
Pretty much every day, yeah.
Oh. Well, don't... I learned that Comet does not make a good substitute.
God, nope.
Yeah.
It'll exfoliate you, along with probably a lot of other things.
Yeah.
Did it burn? Did you get that burning sensation?
Yeah, it didn't matter how much, you know, Lubriderm I applied to it, yeah. It didn't get better.
Yeah. I can honestly say I've never had that happen to me before.
Yeah.
Is that something I need to watch out for in my old age?
Yeah, don't use Comet.
Jeez.
It's not good in the hair either. Just saying.
Okay. Life advice from a guy that just chugged half a bottle of Jack. And he's still flying, ladies and gentlemen.
I wonder if DC just...
The more you know. Yep.
You
more
need that,
you know.
You need that little jingle afterwards, right?
Yeah. Oh my God. That's too funny.
911, what's your emergency?
I'm a dumbass! It reminds me of a cartoon a long time ago. A guy lying in a hospital bed, he's all bandaged up, right? The only thing you can see is his nose and his eyes. And he's talking to his wife, and he goes, "Oh yeah, you can pull those back to like 1650. Nope, those are your throttles.
Okay. All right, go ahead.
So he says to his wife, he goes, "Can you believe they would put flammable on a container and not underline it?"
Well, here's another life lesson I've got for you. So, not this wife. Went shopping.
Yeah.
Saw my favorite adult beverage.
Uh-huh.
Put it in the cart. This is when you're young, right? You got no money.
Right.
Put it
just wheeled it out in the parking lot without paying.
Yeah. So, squeaking along, and she catches me putting it in the cart and tells me to put it back because they can't afford it.
Right.
Or we can't afford it. So I'm like, all right, fine. We'll just put it back.
Oh, so turn.
Nope.
Okay, so our next... Sorry.
No worries.
Our next direct is going to be... SPI. What's going on here?
It broke.
Whew! Okay. Central U.S.
Brother, Christian approved. Have a nice day.
Oh. So, anyway, so we get shopping along, and, you know, I'm bummed out. I can't have my adult beverage.
Right.
So we get in there, and all of a sudden she's putting this cream in the basket. And I go, "What's that?" She's like, "Well, that's my face cream." said, well, we can't afford that. She goes, well, it makes me look beautiful. And I told her, that bottle of whiskey will make you beautiful, too.
Yeah,
that wasn't the right thing to say.
Didn't go over?
No.
That's what the whiskey's for.
Roger, once you do point out,
I don't understand why she didn't find that funny.
I could go into it, but I think at this point, if you haven't got picked up on, yeah, you're done.
Okay. Maybe that's why I ended up divorced.
Probably some good reasoning there. Yeah, X-Plane 11's really starting to show its age.
Starting?
Yeah, look at the clouds. Look at that cloud layer, right?
Yeah, I know.
The two side monitors are fine, but for some reason we got this weird inversion going on with the colors on the front screen.
Yeah, and why is that?
I don't know. I really don't know. I've got no add-ons affecting the weather or anything, so I don't know why it's doing that. Damn, dude.
It sounds like you need more beer.
Oh, I forgot to turn on the cabin pressure.
It's a good thing we're not going over 12,000.
Right. So, a little bit of pre-planning here for Galveston. So at 10 miles out of Galveston, we need to contact the tower.
Okay.
State our intentions.
Okay. Now, does that including that we're landing to pick up moonshine? That's our intention?
We could probably leave that part out.
Oh. Is that disclosing too much?
That's, yeah. On a need-to-know basis, they don't need to know that.
In YOLO Air, I didn't think that was really an issue.
You'd be surprised. All right, I'm going to see. I'm going to tune in ATIS.
Oh, for Galveston.
Galveston.
Contact. You have information. Howdy. Jolt International at Galveston Airport. Information. Howdy. 1852 Zulu. Weather observation. Wind 090 at 910 miles, visibility, clear skies, temperature 29er, dew point 23, altimeter 29er, 98, landing and departing runway 14, visual approach runway 14 in use. DHU and Shoals International Galveston Airport would like to welcome the USA Flying Club and the Pilot Club to today's VFR flying event. We hope you have fun. Advise controller on initial contact. You have information. Howdy.
Howdy? Howdy! Information, howdy, partner. So, you know, that guy that we're hearing right now sounds like he is in most desperate need for a pool.
Yes.
Just say it.
Yes.
Departing runway 14. Visual approach runway 14 in use. DHU and Shoals International at Galveston Airport would like to welcome the USA Flying Club and the Pilot Club to today's VFR flying event. We hope you have fun. Advise controller on initial contact.
If I need to just being super professional, then you got these two clowns flying.
What's he trying to say?
Well, we're still alive. That's got to count for something. I think I'm going to cry.
It's so funny, the professionalism of flying DC jets and then
us.
One of these two clown cars.
Exactly.
Oh. I guess we should switch back over, huh? We got information, howdy.
Yeah, we're going to go over to Tower, I think, then.
Yeah, I think Tower's probably the best.
Tower's a good choice. What do you think?
Yeah, we'll just hang out there.
125.7.
And then keep us 122.8 on guard.
Yeah.
Landing and departing runway 14. Visual approach runway 14 in use.
So 14 is in use, okay.
Galveston Airport would like to welcome the USA Flying Club and the Pilot Club to today's VFR flying event. We hope you have fun. Advise control.
Guard.
Yeah, you notice that he gives the shout out to the pilot flying club, and YOLO is not even worthy of a mention.
I know.
What's up with that?
Go figure.
This should be interesting, though, to see how this all goes.
Yeah.
The shit show is about to begin.
Yep.
The goat rodeo.
Goat rodeo. So we're coming in on 1-4.
Yep.
So what will probably... That's... Okay, wow, that's interesting. So I wonder how they're going to have us come in.
Usually at a descending altitude.
Usually. I wonder if they're going to have us come in like right here and put us on a downwind 45. So we'll fly downwind and then base and final since we're VFR.
I'm sure. Which way are we coming from though, remember?
So we're coming in from this direction.
Right, so, yeah, they could have us go around. They could,
they could just say, state your intentions. So this
the
is...
Party!
Like it's 1990-100. So this will be interesting. I've never done VFR flight into an airport without first adhering to their traffic patterns.
Okay, so that's what we need to look up. Do they have any instructions on runway 14?
Let's see.
That's what we need to look up, right? No? So we look at approach 14. Well, they don't.
Okay, I'm gonna do a little sleight of hand here.
Hey, rookie, why don't you pull my head out of my butt?
Not backtrack again.
And presto. Not that kind of sleight of hand.
No, not that kind of sleight of hand.
Okay.
Okay. Go ahead and engage heading hold here. So that's set, and then you press this one. Press it in once.
Okay.
That'll slave the heading bug to where your current heading, and then you just hit.
Oh, really?
Heading. Yeah.
Okay.
So now we can go direct to Shoals, which is what I want. It will not tell the autopilot to do anything, but what it will tell us is our distance to the airport.
The Galveston Tower.
So we just monitor our flight here, and we make sure that we contact tower before we get like within, I'd say 15 miles.
November 11.
Yeah. He's going to be busy, and he's going to have to figure out how to fit us in.
Yeah.
299 or 8, enter right traffic, runway 1.
299 or 8. Is his altimeter.
Yep.
And we should be at that.
Yeah, let's just get
since
there.
We're below 18.
Oh, you already got it. Okay.
I'm sorry, I had some other radio traffic there. Can you confirm left downwind runway 14?
Who is that?
11816.
Oh.
Enter right traffic, runway 14, report on the right downwind.
Okay, enter right traffic.
Yeah, they're putting you into the pattern.
Okay, so I've never done VFR, so this is going to be interesting.
Okay, so let's see. Right traffic into 14 is going to be here, like out here, right? Left traffic for 14 is going to be inside the airport boundary. So we're going to, if they say left traffic for 14, we're going to fly downwind, base, and then final. If they say right traffic, it's going to be on this side of the airport, and then downwind, base, final.
Okay.
So regardless of which downwind they put us on, we have to figure out how to get there.
Alrighty.
and traffic altitude or pattern altitude. Oh, that's a good question. What is pattern altitude? It's probably going to be 1,500 feet. Since the airport elevation is only 6 feet, going to 1,500 will be just perfect. That's weird that the chart doesn't tell you traffic pattern altitude. However, the fallback is 1,500 feet. Or 1,000 feet.
Or how about 800? 1,800?
No. I think 1,000 feet is probably a good traffic altitude.
Okay. Well, we've got...
But we can always ask the tower.
We've got 71.5 more miles to really flub this up.
Okay, well, that's plenty of opportunity to just bury the nose. You know what I mean, Vern?
All right. Looks like we're coming up on our next VOR, coming up on Sabine Pass. And then we'll make our turn into Galveston.
So actually, that might work out really well. So we'll probably initiate a descent right about here. And then 1-4 is this way.
Right.
So if we're coming in at almost a 90 degree, that'll set us up real nice for either downwind.
Yeah. We just need to know turn before or after the airport.
Yeah.
Sounds like a neato plan to me.
I want to see their faces when we make the initial call. Galveston Tower, YOLOS 209, inbound, full stop. I'm probably like, oh god, these guys again.
I know.
So usually, traffic pattern altitude VFR is 1,000 feet. Usually. But, like you said, traffic pattern VFR altitude at Point King County is 1,800.
So, once again, our lack of research has put us in a quinky-dink.
We'll just ask Tower. Are we descending? Because I got some pressure.
Does this plane have an APU?
My ears are popping, among other things. Looks like we're going to make a left turn to 243.
Say, what?
I'm thinking, no, maybe 240. So once we pass over SSBI, just dial up your heading to 240. And we'll watch this and make sure that let's contact them at 20 miles out. Let's be nice.
Got
plenty of time to work this traffic.
It doesn't sound like he's getting that much traffic right now.
No.
I just hope we have scenery to land in.
Oh. The following scenery package has a problem and therefore will not be loaded.
Oh, it's Houston.
Oh.
Kodiak 816 is right now.
Unbelievable. Dude.
Kodiak 816, runway 14, clear to land.
Global scenery?
Your global scenery is dead.
What the heck?
Yeah, your scenery INI is messed up, dude.
Well, that stinks.
So there's no globe. We're gonna land in the water.
We're gonna land in the water. Well, this will be fun.
0 miles to the southwest. Information. Howdy. Full stop.
Howdy. Full stop.
64 Kilo Papa, Galveston Tower, good afternoon. Thanks for information. Howdy. Enter right traffic, runway 14, report midfield downwind.
Right traffic.
Right traffic, 14, report midfield, 64 Kilo Papa.
Enter right traffic report midfield. Okay.
This could be very interesting. I bet you the airport will be. Let's hope the airport's there.
I hope the airport's there.
If not, this will be one of those. We're gonna have to disconnect.
Yeah. Well, shoot.
Yeah, it's the scenery, dude. So what we'll do, as soon as we land, let's fix your INI file.
Yeah.
We'll get that all quinky-dinked out. Have you loaded all of your scenery yet?
Yeah. It's all loaded.
The entire United States?
Yeah. I don't know why it's complaining about missing global scenery. That's kind of a shocker.
But that tells me it's not in the right order.
Okay.
I'll go with that. Unless you deleted your global scenery.
No. Why would I do that? Oh, late night drunken binges might have an effect on that, wouldn't it?
I've heard studies that say that consumption of great amount of alcohol can lead to poor decisions.
Drink to that.
Just saying. I've read studies on that.
Well, alrighty then. Yeah, he's putting people on the right downwind, so, yeah. So what we will do is we will end up flying a little bit south of the airport and then make kind of a circuitous route back to the downwind. We'll enter the downwind at a 45 and then report midfield.
All right.
If they tell us to report midfield.
He should be keeping an eye on us, shouldn't he, as well?
He doesn't care about us. We're VFR. He does not care.
Tower Moody 624 kilopop, turning midfield downwind 14.
He's turning midfield downwind 114.
Tower runway 14, clear to land, wind 090 at Niner, traffic on the runway, be exiting prior to arrival.
Clear to land 14, Moody 624 kilopop, thanks.
Kodiak 816, left turn onto runway 18, exit taxiway Charlie, contact ground. Have a good night.
Alright, left on 18 and right on Charlie over to ground, Kodiak 816.
Oh, is ground up as well?
Yeah.
Nice! Hopefully we have a ground 2 talk to.
I hope we do.
Talk about a roll of the dice!
Yeah, shoot!
And the tower, I'm not seeing ground frequency. Are we 0.9er?
He should be on 118.62.
1862, thank you.
Boy, another professional sounding guy on the radio. Great.
Yeah, and then here comes these yahoos.
You know, they do that on purpose just to make you look bad, right?
You think so?
Yeah, it's all a conspiracy, dude.
Okay, good. No, it's not us. All right, there's our turn.
Oh, 240, you said?
Yep, down here.
Oh.
Yeah, we can, let's start our descent.
All right.
Get us down. Yep, there we go. Ooh, watch your altitude bug. Oh, never mind. Oh, yeah, you can set your altitude to, we can make it, what do you think, 2,000?
How about 3, and just we'll judge it from there.
Well, 3,000 is the cutoff between flying whatever altitude you want and altitude plus 500.
Oh, so 2,500?
Yeah, let's go, 2,500. Anything below 3,000, all bets are off.
Tower, good afternoon. Pilot Club 306, type Kodiak with you, 15 miles to the southwest, with the numbers inbound for full stop.
With the numbers, what does that mean?
With the numbers, I think he's talking about ATIS.
Galveston Tower, good afternoon. Enter right traffic, runway 14, report midfield downwind.
So, what we want to do...
To the right traffic for 14 and report...
Is we want to end up, like, right here. Right on the G.
Okay.
So let's turn our altitude in a little bit. What do you think?
A little bit more left.
So I'm kind of thinking. Oh wait, okay, this is it.
64 Kilo Papa, welcome to Galveston. You can make a left turn on runway
230.
Exit at Charlie. Contact ground. Good night.
Left turn on 18. Exit Charlie. All right,
descending through 10,000. Landing lights coming on.
Okay.
Descent checklist, please.
Descent checklist.
Ocean check.
Yeah, plenty of that. Auto ignitions are on, good. We got airport ATIS information, altimeters, those are set, 2998. Radios are set, auto feather armed. Auto feather armed. And indicated, speed will be below 250 knots. Okay.
I'm not seeing them, but I'll give them a try.
Okay. Fuel balance, yep, looks good. Okay, descent checklist complete.
I saw him earlier.
Galveston Tower, back up 841,
1800 miles. Outclub 841, Galveston Tower. Good afternoon. The Galveston altimeter 2995, enter right traffic runway
2995.
Yeah. Towards, on the downwind traffic ahead of you.
Okay, set.
Right traffic. Well,
he's got to be having a blast working tower.
All right, we'll report pretty right.
Let's give us a little bit more left.
More left?
Like three or four more degrees left.
I'm sorry, I just lost my voice there for a sec. We'll report prepare for the right turn downwind for the...
You ever flown a traffic pattern by hand? Nope.
Following is about 5 miles, 12 o'clock, 1,000.
I've always flown the tubers.
Yep.
Kodiak.
That's why I wanted to do it. I mean, I've never done this before, so.
So basically, you're just flying squares or rectangles.
Okay, I'm looking up.
I didn't know rectangles flew. What? Well, they. Never mind. I'm so confused.
Galveston Tower, Skymaster 3499 Mike is 15 to the southwest with information. Howdy, inbound full stop.
Skymaster 3499 Mike, Galveston Tower, good afternoon. Thanks for information. Howdy, enter left traffic. Correction, enter right traffic, runway 14. And report on the 45.
And the Mike, enter right traffic.
Report on the 45.
Yep. So,
yeah.
Report on the 45, so real quick, so here's our runway that we're going to be landing. We're landing this way, right? We're going to enter on the 45 to the downwind, which is here. So when we're established on the 45, that's when he's going to radio in and contact tower that he's established on the 45. And then pilot's discretion will be when he wants to decide to turn downwind. Okay. Did you get all that?
Sure. Yeah. And aptitude check. Got it.
Okay. And he's exactly where we want to be, 15 miles southwest of the airport. That'll give us plenty of breathing room, plenty of time to get the kinks figured out. Or wrinkles.
Well, by the looks of all that water below,
ooh, watch your engine.
What am I watching it do?
Not smoke them. Let's check our engines. Uh-oh. So here's what we do. Okay. All right, we're not on fire anymore.
We just...
we almost lost the right engine. Oh my God. Look at that.
Traffic, Pilot Club 306 is on the right
down. That duct tape, I love it.
Yeah. It's below deck, left wing.
I
like that view too. Dude, you did an awesome job on this paint.
Oh, fuck it.
Alright.
You know, it only took me a day to do it.
That's it?
Wow. A solid day, though. I mean,
so actually, let's do this. Let's fly to this waypoint. GLSCD.
All right, sounds good.
Let's see if we get that in the database. I don't know if it'll actually be in the database. GLSCD.
It's a waypoint.
Intersection.
There at intersection.
Okay, hit nav.
There you go. Look at that. Looky, looky.
And since we're about equidistant from here to here and here to here, that'll put us 30 miles to the southwest of Galveston.
High Club 841. Traffic to follow is a...
Give us plenty of time for that 45. Yeah, I see a lot of water and houses down there. You know, part of the problem, I think, is because this part of the country is so close to sea level.
I don't have that problem, though.
Really? Well, I do. And I don't know why, and I don't like it. I don't like it one bit.
911, what's your emergency?
I have a problem with all the water around here, friend. Friend!
I'm going to slow our descent a little bit.
Yeah.
Oh, look at your engines. Why do they keep doing that?
Because you're descending.
I'm going to slow our descent.
I'm going to check our smokage. All right, we're not on fire. That's part of our checklist. Make sure the engines are not on fire.
Alcott 123, Galveston Tower. Good afternoon. Enter right traffic, runway 14, report on the downwind.
Yeah, that whole city's underwater.
Yeah, it's almost like they had a great flood.
Most of 9M mics on the 45 to enter right down.
Although, that's kind of a contradiction in terms, isn't it? Great flood.
Traffic to follow is now on a pretty bright base. Runway 140 is traffic.
I'm not seeing any traffic.
It's a good point.
Okay. And Mike will continue until we see point.
Sub 306, welcome to Galveston. Left turn on the runway.
There's traffic right there.
Charlie, contact ground.
Okay.
118.62, see you.
Left on the 36, then right on to Charlie for Pilot Club 306. If it is indeed your birthday, happy birthday. Thank you.
It's not.
I don't think so.
I've noticed a lot of people will do that. They'll just say, hey, happy birthday to a controller.
Yeah.
And everybody, oh, it's his birthday! And then,
it's not my birthday!
3141 Papa, Galveston Tower. Thanks for information, howdy. Enter right traffic, runway 14.
You should call it Information Hippopotamus.
Yeah.
Or Information Hippo.
Oh, we gotta remember to cancel VFR.
No, I don't. Oh, just right before touchdown.
Right before touchdown, cancel. Yeah.
No,
runway in sight. Cancel. We'd like to cancel VFR.
I don't know. Do you think you can take that? Okay.
So yeah. Why not?
Runway 14. Line up, Mike. Turning right base. Clear to land. Runway 14.
I don't know. This isn't an event. I don't think we'd want to.
Oh, I'm doing it. I'm totally doing it. Our altitude, we busted our altitude.
How did we do that? Whoa, why didn't it catch?
Oh, we didn't have altitude capture armed. So now we got to go up, turn your VSI bug to a positive value, and then hit altitude.
Follow the Skymaster, turning base to final about
2 miles. That'll put us back up to 2,500.
Interesting. Okay. Yeah, your system's just a wee bit different than mine. Just a tad.
Alcove 123, traffic to follow the twins at the Cessna Skymaster, turning base to final. 1,200, report that traffic site.
Okay, I'm going to put you on kind of a wide downwind. So you can, so you've got a little bit of time for your base and final turn.
Oh, okay, yeah. That's fine by me.
Uh-oh. Oh, that's us.
One Tower, minute. Please. Tower wants to get a hold... Oh, Tower wants us to get a hold of him.
Yeah.
Right? Wow, he wants you to contact him now.
Yeah. Galveston Tower, Yolo 209, go ahead.
Nine Galveston Tower, good afternoon. You entered my airspace there on the south side. I just wanted to say, get your intentions.
Oh. I didn't see that we entered it.
That's okay.
All right. Yeah, sorry for busting airspace. We're headed 30 miles southwest of Galveston Airport. We're going to overfly GLSCD fix and then turn inbound on the 45.
Yellow 209. Galveston Tower, okay, roger. Use caution, numerous VFR aircraft inbound from the southwest. I recommend you maintain 2,000 or above, and call me when you're back inbound.
Copy that. We're going to hold at 2,500 feet, and we'll keep an eye out for traffic, yellow 209.
Oh, club 423, traffic.
How did we bust that airspace?
I don't know.
Your right nose on final. Give that
I don't, it doesn't right show that we did it.
We weren't even close to his airspace. We weren't even close.
I didn't think we were, because look at, here's his airspace right here. Or at least, maybe we scared him.
Could be.
Probably because he didn't know what the hell we were doing.
Right.
He's probably looking at it going, what are those yo-yos doing? No sim has that problem.
Thanks for that. Follow that traffic.
So what we can do, we can go direct back to the airport once
yeah,
we overfly
that's what
this.
I say.
And
yeah.
once I hit direct here,
yeah,
the airplane will turn in.
Yeah, no, I say we'll just do the direct.
Okay.
And this will let them know we're back to the inbound 45.
Yep.
And, looking for traffic, but I'm not seeing any in our area.
Yeah, not yet. As soon as we overfly this, though, we can go to our traffic display.
We can turn right now, dude.
Like
want to?
Yeah. Let's just...
Galveston ground.
There we go.
There she goes. And then...
Galveston Tower, Bonanza 1169, Tango.
There's our traffic.
8.5
So we got a guy ahead of us, 900 feet below, and then...
Alright.
And Bonanza 1169 or Tango, Galveston Tower.
Once we level out, you're going to let them know we're...
Enter right traffic, runway 14, report on the downwind.
Right traffic, runway 14, we'll report on the downwind. Bonanza 69 or Tango.
Club 123, execute a left 360 immediately for traffic.
Let's slow to 200.
Tower
November
574
kilo off on the ramp
right in
taxi.
We did.
Calling for taxi, contact ground 1.62.
What's wrong?
I'm still looking for evidence that we busted his airspace.
We'll be able to have to investigate that whenever we get on the ground here.
Yeah.
What speed did you say you wanted?
200.
All right.
Club 123, when you finish your 360...
Because this is all VFR traffic, so they're going to be a lot slower. We might have to back off to like 160, or even slower.
He just had somebody execute an immediate 360.
Yeah. So yeah, we might have to look at this. So he's about 10 miles out ahead of us. This guy's off our... 8 o'clock. So his diamond is full. I think that means that he's in closer proximity.
Yeah. As long as we're not CBDR.
The 3141 Papa,
yeah.
Welcome to Galveston. Contact ground 118.62. See you next time.
All right. We're inbound 45. Okay. 200 knots.
Yep.
Pilot Club 123, thanks for the help. Traffic no longer.
Oh, arrived. Information howdy.
14, clear to land, wind 100 at 10.
Runway 14,
Galveston Tower, yellow 209, inbound on the 45, about 10 miles southwest of the airport, full stop 14.
Yellow 209, Galveston Tower, information howdy's current, altimeter 29 or 9 or 5. Cross midfield at or above 1,500, enter left traffic, runway 14, and report on the downwind.
Left traffic. We'll enter the banner at 1,500, we'll make left traffic for runway 14, yellow 209.
Yellow 209, actually, the instruction was cross midfield at or above 1,500. And enter left downwind runway 14. Report on the downwind.
We'll report on the downwind. We'll cross midfield at 1500 feet for left downwind for runway 14, yellow 209.
Jib.
Galveston Bonanza 116 center tank.
So we got to get down to 15. Yeah, 15, and let's slow to 150.
Traffic on the runway exiting prior to your arrival.
So,
to land.
Well, first, I'm going to dial in 1500 here, vertical speed,
yeah,
there we go, and vertical speed, and altitude capture. Hey, I remember this time! All right.
123, exit left on the runway.
I should get a gold star!
Contact ground 118.62, have a good night.
Alright, it looks like we're going to have a runway to land in, though. There's, I got the field in sight.
Oh, okay.
You see the field? And we should go ahead and flip to the other.
Yeah, so let's get set up for landing. This is going to happen real quick.
Yep.
Okay.
Hello, 209. Are you able to make right traffic runway 14?
Yeah, we can make a right traffic 14, yellow 209.
209, enter right traffic, runway 14, report on the downwind.
Alright, report on the downwind, yellow 209. We're on right traffic 14. So I want to go to the left here, turn left.
Nope, not yet.
We're still going, we're flying the same heading, but we're not going to cross midfield. Right, but dude, we're almost there. Like, we got it.
Okay, I see what you're saying.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So yeah, let's turn left. Left heading 318. Why isn't this thing turning? Left. Oh. Oh, look at all that traffic. Yep, I got him over here.
Yeah, all right. We got an airport too.
Yeah, that's going to be tight.
Yeah.
That's be tight. I'm going to put, let's get gear and flaps down. All right.
It's going to be real tight.
Gear coming down.
Okay.
And flaps.
Maneuver 116, Manor Tango, welcome to Galveston. Contact ground 118.62. Have a good night.
Over to ground. Good night, Manor 600 Tango.
And speed over the fence is going to be 125.
Okay.
209, runway 14, clear to land, wind 100 at 10.
Alright. Galveston Tower, yellow 209, established on downwind for right traffic 14.
Yellow 209, runway 14, clear to land, wind 100 at 10.
Clear to land, runway 14, yellow 209. Alright. Do you got the runway down there?
Not yet. But we will find it. We've got to keep, let's keep our speed around 140. I mean, these turns are going to be sharp. I would not rely on
that. No, I was getting ready to go. I was getting ready to go full stupid.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, let's make right base. And that'll be a heading of 030.
All right, do what?
Right turn to 030.
Okay. 030. Okay, you got full flaps, good. Props, I'm going to push all the way forward. And I think just continue the turn to heading 140. Yeah, that's what my intent was. Because this is going to be
Galveston a short... Tower, Bonanza 3A Romeo 1000.
Okay, watch your altitude.
Inbound full stop.
Bonanza 3A Romeo Galveston.
You see the runway yet? Got it.
All right, you're in there. All right, good job. Good job.
In the right traffic, 1-4-4-6-2 midfield downwind, Bonanza 3A Romeo.
Okay, we're ready to go over to ground when we get down there. Okay, good. Good job. Yeah, look at you. Having the screen set up this way helps you fly this one so much easier.
I noticed. Yeah, you nailed it.
Did we? Yeah, we did flip over.
Yep.
Approaching 146,000 feet available.
Good job. And we are going to exit to the right. If we can make Delta, that first high-speed taxiway. Okay.
I doubt we can. We might have to cross the opposing runway, but
turn right. Yeah, I'm not seeing any taxiways there, buddy.
Caution. Well, if we turn left on that first taxiway.
Oh, turn left.
Yeah, but we're not going to make that. I don't think that's like 1,500 feet.
Speeds 125, nailed. Gears down, flaps are set. All yours, mon capitan.
Let's not try for this first high speed.
No,
I think that's risking it. We'll just take her all the way to the end.
Minimums.
Landing. Job. All right. Nope.
Throttle up and back.
Now I know why the co-pilot guards the levers with his hand.
Oh, just so he doesn't pull the wrong ones?
Yeah. Okay, that's good. And we'll take her all the way to the end. We'll make a left-hand turn on Bravo.
Left-hand turn on Bravo. Yep. All right. Oh, ground just went offline. Darn it. Really?
Yeah.
They were scared of us.
Yeah. They saw us coming like, oh hell no.
Sorry, 5 kilo with you.
Oh, is he back?
No. That was just somebody saying with
Yellow
you.
Yellow 209, welcome to Galveston. Left turn at the end and contact ground 118.62.
We'll go ahead and switch over anyway because I think he's there.
Yeah. We'll make a left turn on Bravo here. Yellow 209.
Remaining.
974 kilo alpha Galveston Tower.
Yeah, 5 kilo alpha.
All right.
Go past the hold short.
Yep.
Galveston Tower, looks like ground just went offline.
No, he's there. It's just at Galveston, the radar sights are too low, so he may not show up in the text chat, but he's there.
Okay.
Galveston ground, yellow 209. We are off at Bravo. Any terminal, any gate.
209 Galveston ground, you must be severely sick because we don't have a terminal nor a gate. Taxi to park and be a Bravo. See you later.
Just sit back and go, I told you we landed at the wrong spot.
All right, Galveston ground, yellow 209, copy, and we like to cancel VFR.
Cancel VFR?
You did have to do it, didn't you? I had to. He's just probably talking to Ryan like, did you just hear what I heard? All the other pilots are going, what? yep.
So that happened.
All you YOLO flyers out there.
I know.
All right, we're going to fix this scenery.
Sierra, contact Galveston Tower 1.
Hey, Dave, welcome aboard.
12057, see you later, 2-wing 0.
There's a terminal right there. They've got terminals.
Then we'll make a right here.
See, look at that, there's a terminal.
I look at all the power lines here. Isn't that beautiful? You know, I think they don't have enough.
I think they need more. Because more is good.
Oh my God.
All right.
Yeah. For a simulator that doesn't pay any attention to VFR scenery, they sure added a lot of freaking power lines. Okay, flaps are up, taxi lights are on, good job. Landing lights are off, elevator trim, set for takeoff. Transponder, we are squawking 1200. All right. Yeah, Flight DC just, we got a problem with the... Seaplane hangar. What is this? Is it an outside view? You... It says the anchor's been deployed.
you turned into the seaplane hangar.
Oh, God, that's funny.
Okay, well, that was interesting. Shutdown checklist, parking brake set.
Set.
Throttles are light. Just turn everything off. Avionics off. Okay, well.
That's never happened to me before in this ever.
Alrighty!
And
then,
I like the PFDs.
Oh, they are, they're upside down, aren't they? Okay. Well, I think this concludes our flight.
This concludes our flight.
What, did somebody... Oh.
Oh my God.
All right, well, I think that concludes this flight for today.
Yeah,
we got some scenery work to do.
And we might have to break out the desiccant to dry out the cabin.
Anybody want to buy a slightly waterlogged 1900 Delta?
Oh, I can't even shut the engines down.
No, you can't.
We're done.
All righty, guys. Okay. Well...
thanks for joining.
Yeah.
We certainly appreciate your patronage. I'm gonna have to have a hit of that. Okay.
Alrighty, guys.
Alright, thanks. Everybody
for
joining.
Deck of YOLO 209.
See ya! That's all we can add. Turn everything off. I want to play us out.
You have choices when you fly. That's why the people at YOLO Airlines are surprised when you choose us.
When the YOLO jets are flying, some days we're really trying. Sometimes it's almost like we care.
A family trip, that special friend, an important customer. Whatever your reason to fly, you might get there safely on YOLO Airlines.
Some pilots make it look so easy.
Every YOLO flight is an adventure. Every in-flight meal, a trip to the lavatory.
You'll be really glad to learn. We love to fly, but we don't know how. We don't try very hard, and it shows.
You'll never be late, because we never depart on time. So sit back, try to relax, and let YOLO pilots point out the sights.
Peter says port... our anus, not the right wing. Isn't that what he said?
Port.
What?
Port. Can't even say it.
That's the way it sounds like, right?
Port. No, I'm saying port our anus. Our anus sass. Aaron sass. Or... Uranus.
You only live once. That's the spirit of YOLO Airlines. So when you're ready to fly, there's one airline ready to serve you. Poorly.
YOLO, we love to fly, and we'll learn somehow. We don't know how to fly, and it shows.
Holy crap!
We're done.
That didn't go well.